The microbial world. From the Asgard Archaea, named after the Viking gods Thor and Loki, and no, this is not the next Avengers movie, to the Water Bear, lone survivor of the apocalypse. Again, not a superhero movie, but this is a fascinating world. But today I'm not going to talk about potential Marvel characters because I work on bacteria. Bacteria are everywhere. In fact, their collective weight is equivalent to 50 billion elephants. They dominate every environment, in our gut, on our skin, in the air we breathe and the water we drink, but also in the deepest oceans, hottest deserts and coldest lands on Earth. We can't see them, but they can make large-scale changes to our ecosystems. Now imagine the Arctic and its bare, pristine landscape, too cold for most wildlife to survive, and yet bacteria thrive. In this ecosystem, they can take in carbon dioxide and methane, two of the leading gases involving climate change, and store it in the frozen soils. But the Arctic is the fastest warming region in the world, and storing the most organic carbon. As those frozen soils start thawing, the rate of release of those climate active gases is increased. So they have key roles in our ecosystems, and yet there's still so much we don't know about them. How many they are, who they are, what they do. Do they travel around the world or stay in one place for their entire little lives? Well, those are some of the questions of my PhD. So first, I traveled to the northernmost territory, to the land of the White Walkers. I made it beyond the wall and I collected soils to extract DNA. Then I spent long days and nights on my computer making sense of millions of DNA sequences. From our results, there are two things I can tell you now. First is that the environment is key in determining who we can identify, especially pH and organic carbon. Two is that bacteria are just like us. Some travel around the world and explore new territories, and others don't and stay in one place. Okay, they're not exactly like us. It's unlikely they can decide when and where to go, but still they can have adaptations making them more likely to disperse. And in fact, I found that the most abundant species disperse the furthest. So this study provided a baseline database of bacterial diversity in Arctic soils that could be used to better understand carbon cycling, but also to evaluate the potential release of those climate active gases to the atmosphere from the thawing Arctic soils. There's still a lot we don't know, but one thing's for sure, we'd be better off if winter was coming. Thank you.